it's like a three-dimensional painting, and of course the painting is really like connected with Italy, of course, and I wanted to make a work that was that is like a you know, normally a painting is like a window, right, that you look into, but I put it like on the floor, and it's like a room where you look into, but at the same time it's also like a painting, and like the colors, it's a composition with these four colors, and then I looked for I found out that the bathroom is a perfect room to make a composition with colors, because in the bathroom you have towels, and towels have different colors, and you can use these towels. You can put them on the floor, but you can also hang them over a bathtub. You can hang them over a chair. So that was a way to make a two-dimensional composition. And I made the composition of these colors in a way like a modernistic painting, but at the same time it also refers to it's also like a Renaissance painting, or like and also the colors are like not you know, it are not colors that, for example, Mondrian would use. Like they are off colors, like more poetic colors are like. You know, the pink is a bit too dark pink, and the yellow is, you know, it's a kind of, more kind of poetic way of making this composition. Yeah. So all the materials in the installation, all the objects are self-made. In the same as in the painting. In the painting, if you make the image of a chair in a painting, it's also painted and remade. And so also, I thought it's very logical to remake the chairs, or remake the make an image of a bathtub, and the image of a figure. And when you want to make a figure, it's very logical to use wet clay. And the bathtub is very logical to put wet clay in, because it can stand water. So I took wet clay out of the bathtub and put it around this piece of wood, and I created the image of a figure around the wood. So it's very logical way of thinking, but maybe a more poetic way of thinking. Yeah. Yeah.
Stay on the materials. Mm-hmm. I want to know because I noticed that you use organic materials, mm-hmm, to make something like very rational, modernistic.
I'm not talking about
this installation, but and then you use not organic materials to make figures. Something like it's the opposite of
nature. But maybe it's also important to say is that. For example, in this installation, the wet clay is not wet clay, but it's fake. It's not real. It's hard, and it's epoxy. But it looks like wet, and it looks like
it's polished.
It's a hard material, and but it looks like it is wet clay that you still can change. Also, in this case, if it was real wet clay, you know, in the bathtub it's covered with plastic, but the figure is not covered with plastic. So after a few days it would crack and be dry. But I like that it's this moment, just after when it was almost finished, I stopped working, and I left out of this stage, but it's like a. Something between a working place and a bathroom. It's a bathroom where an artist made this figure. But
great, thank you. And what about this publication that you made?
I thought it was really interesting for me. Also, maybe I want to say that for me it was very also logical and beautiful to make a work about painting in this collection, because this collection is really lots of it's very very rich in the it's a beautiful collection of many many paintings, and I think it's really the connection is really interesting that my work. The first work that is really about painting of me comes in this collection. That is, so for me that's really perfect. But for this artist book, I thought it was really interesting to make a book with, because I make photographs in my studio, sometimes it's very interesting how objects in my studio move and become works, and sometimes not become works. And for example, the second image in the book is like a very early stage of this room.
Yeah.
It's just this rough idea of a bathtub here.
We have the chair.
And in the beginning, it was I have pieces of wood that were going to be figures. I made two figures, but finally I decided to use only one figure. It was better. And so, so in this book you can see lots of images from my studio of different periods, and you can see how some objects move from other and become a work or are sometimes not. And And for example, here you can see that it's really a big space where I. Work on many works at once, and just objects move from here to there, and then they become.
But what drives you to move the object in the studio?
Because I want to create content, and I want to create something that is stronger than my thinking. I want to create something that once it's finished, every time when I look at it. It creates new thoughts, and so I'm looking for this moment that suddenly something magical happens, and this thing that I made becomes more powerful than my own thoughts, and that's what I'm looking for.
Great.
Yeah.